main reason we're really pissed off with TTIP is because it gives increased power to pharmaceutical companies, meaning they can charge us a lot more for drugs. And we don't really know how much we pay for drugs because we still have a small NHS system here, but it could potentially cost our health systems in the EU billions if TTIP gets through. And this is because pharmaceutical industry is the third richest industry in the world. It is incredibly lucrative. It's been one of the first things to secure in the TTIP negotiations. The reason they make so much money is because of a patenting system. It means when they produce a drug, they get a 20-year monopoly on a drug. Nobody else can produce it. There's no competition. And as a result, they can charge whatever price they like. And they do. Roche has just produced a new drug for breast cancer, and it costs £90,000. It's an incredibly good drug. It has basically no side effects, but the NHS can't afford it. Luckily, we have generic drugs. These are identical legal copies of brand name drugs. It's like when you go to Boots and you buy paracetamol instead of Panadol, it has exactly the same active ingredients, it's just at a fraction of the cost. So generic drugs save our national health system, actually health systems in the EU in general, about £20 billion annually. So we need to secure this. But TTIP will allow pharmaceutical companies to extend patents on drugs and even to patent drugs which aren't new. So this will cost us in Europe, the health systems, money. It will also cost individual patients money as well. But we must remember that TTIP will set the global standard for all future free trade agreements. That means the countries in the global south who already have limited health budgets, if they want to enter into a free trade agreement, they're going to have to buy by exactly the same intellectual property rights. And for them, this is a much bigger problem. In America, not being able to afford your healthcare is the biggest cause of bankruptcy. But in the global south, it will become a question of life and death. So we've been writing to members of European Parliament, drawing their attention to TTIP and to other free trade agreements that are going on. I have a lot more information, including about how TTIP will also absolve pharmaceutical companies from their responsibility to prove the safety and efficacy of drugs, which is also a major problem. So if you'd like to come and find more information and find out how to take action, then please come and find me. But yeah, keep fighting TTIP. Thanks.